Hi everyone, today I'll be looking at how to use the Tile Inspector in Open Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. The Tile Inspector is an incredibly useful tool. It allows a lot of fine control over objects on your map. Also, for people who are interested in sandbox play, it enables many new opportunities for advanced scenery placement and ride hacking. As you probably know, a game map of Roller Coaster Tycoon is split up into square tiles. For example, Forest Frontiers is 126 by 126, or 15,876 tiles. The game keeps track of each object based on which of those tiles it is placed on. For example, this tile consists of a footpath, and this tile consists of one tree on a sloped surface. We can use a Tile Inspector to list these kinds of objects and adjust them in ways that the base game normally doesn't allow for. In this video, I'll show you the basics of how the Tile Inspector works, and some of the more common things you may want to do with it. Remember that OpenRCT2 is still in development, so the images in this video might not match the version of the game you're playing. To use the Tile Inspector, you'll first need to enable cheats, if you haven't done so already. To do this, go to the Options menu, then the Controls and Interface tab, and finally select Show Toolbar Button for Cheats. You will now see the golden shovel icon appear in the toolbar once you are in a game. Finally, hold down this button and select Show Tile Inspector from the menu. When the Tile Inspector window is open, the cursor changes to show a crosshair, and will highlight the tile you are pointing at. From here, you have two options. You can left-click to select the tile whose surface is highlighted, or you can control left-click to select a specific item, like a piece of track or scenery. If a scenery object or the surface is selected, it will be highlighted on the map so it's more clear which element you've picked. Now that we have selected a tile to look at, let's explore some of the more important parts of the Tile Inspector. At the top, we have the X and Y coordinates of the tile, located on the left side of the toolbar. Below that, we have a list of all the objects on this tile. The one you selected will be highlighted in the list. Below the list, there is the Details pane and the Properties pane, which show extra information about that object. In the top right, the rest of the toolbar contains some important tools. These buttons are for copying the selected element, pasting a copied element, sorting the elements on the tile, rotating the selected element, moving the selected element up and down in the list, and deleting the selected element. Let's take a look at some of the more common things you may want to do with the Tile Inspector. One of the most useful things the Tile Inspector can do is to copy and paste objects. You can copy just about any kind of object, which opens up tons of possibilities. For example, you could move a ride's entrances somewhere else. Just remember that each station can only have at most one entrance and one exit, so you'll have to click Make Usable to set the new entrance as the one you want peeps to actually use, and then delete the old one. You can also copy and paste ride track to make decorative scenery, or track texture. I won't go into all the possibilities here, but you can get a lot of neat effects this way. This column in the element list shows whether any object is invisible or not. You can use the checkbox to turn any object invisible. You can apply this to just about any static object in the map. Scenery, banners, park entrances, paths, and ride track. Everything will still behave normally, you just won't be able to see it. There are endless uses for the invisibility flag. Maybe you might want to hide your park's entrance. Or you could selectively hide some pieces of coaster track to create some fun effects. You can easily raise or lower elements using the arrow buttons here, or rotate them with the rotate button. This is mostly only useful for objects like paths and ride track, but you can also use it to quickly adjust scenery that isn't quite at the right height level. Be careful when doing this with ride track. If you have a piece going in the wrong direction, your trains will crash. You can check the direction a piece of track is facing by checking this column here. When you select a piece of path, you can adjust which of its edges are connected to adjacent tiles. This affects both the appearance of the path piece, as well as the way the piece will navigate. A checkbox means that a peep will be able to leave the selected tile in that direction. You can get some fine control over both the appearance and behavior of paths separately by layering two pieces of path on top of each other. Peeps will follow the one that is lowest in the list, even if it is invisible, while any path above it would be used for display purposes only. So, for example, this path here looks like it branches in two directions, but since the junction is actually two pieces of path, peeps will only follow the bottom one that forces them to go in one direction. This is a simple example, but you can get some very fine-grained control over traffic flow this way. The only buttons in the toolbar that aren't self-explanatory are the ones that change the order of elements in the list, the sort button and the move up and down buttons. Rearranging the order of elements in the list affects what order the game draws them in. This is particularly useful for adjusting scenery. If you have, for example, walls clipping through roofs, you can change the order they are drawn in by moving the roof below the walls. Then the result will look as you would expect. For track pieces with supports, the element ordering will change how the supports are drawn. By rearranging the pieces, you can change the appearance of supports that bend around other tracks, or remove them entirely by ordering the track below the surface. Just be aware that this might cause glitching with some setups when the tracks are over water. Assigning keyboard shortcuts for the tile inspector is also incredibly helpful. With shortcuts, you can be very fast at simple, repetitive tasks. Keyboard shortcuts can be assigned by going into the Options menu, then the Controls and Interface tab, then clicking Shortcut Keys. There is a slot for opening the Tile Inspector at the bottom of the first tab. I've assigned Control T to mine, but of course you can choose whatever you like. You can also assign shortcuts to many actions in the Tile Inspector itself. Rotate Construction Object is by default set to Z and applies here as well. Many more options exist in the third tab of the shortcut window. For example, I've assigned C for copy and V for paste. These are the two items I use most often. Adding shortcuts for increasing and decreasing the element height is also very useful. I made mine R and F, but that's arbitrary, and you might have a better option that works for you. And that's all for this brief look at the Tile Inspector. I didn't cover everything you can do with it. This video is meant to be introductory instead of comprehensive. I encourage you to play around with the tool and take a look at some of the options we didn't explore. Maybe you'll find an interesting feature I didn't mention. Also, be aware that everything I've talked about is subject to change. Remember that OpenRCT 2 is still under development, and this is not an official part of the vanilla game, so the developers may make further changes to this tool. But everything in this video was current as of early December 2021. I hope this video was helpful, and you learned some new tips and tricks on how to hack in OpenRCT 2. If there's something else you'd like me to cover in the future, let me know in the comments.